You want to press real quick?
Nigga, fuck you. What up, though? Man, depression is thick in the fucking building.
Do not put that on Instagram, please.
I'm not.
Please don't, because I don't want them niggas to see that shit. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know what? Go ahead, because they can't find that shit nowhere. I don't give a fuck. Don't close it, though.
I'm not going to close it.
Because like you're about to, man. I got to pour me in the drink.
But okay.
Yeah, it's all good. But what up, man?
What up, though?
Shit, man. You good? You said depression thick in this motherfucker.
Man, I had a rough week.
Well, tell us about it.
Not really.
After you introduce the podcast.
This is Most Known Unknown Podcast. I'm your host, Curt Will. This is episode 10, right?
Yeah.
I got.
Play the air horns for that. That's a milestone, boy.
I know. We ain't been canceled yet.
Yeah, there we go.
That was Asja, who's made a lot of enemies over the past week. About to get into that for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And I got my boy Ant. Yep. And we have a special guest. I'm going to let Asja introduce.
So I've been very excited for this interview because we got one of my favorite producers, platinum producer, local legend. PC, a.k.a. Paycash.
What's up?
Yeah, you got to get air horns for that, too.
What's up, bro? What's going on?
Yeah, man. Good to have you on the show. You are our first guest.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
That's big.
On this podcast.
Yeah.
Let air horns for that, too, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's what's up, bro.
Yeah.
Glad to have you here.
Hey, man. Thank y'all for having me.
Oh, for sure. How y'all week been besides mine's being shitty?
Mine was fantastic. I mean, other than me getting cooked on Twitter and Facebook.
Oh, yeah. You want to talk about that? We can open up the pod talking about that right quick.
I said some things, which wasn't my first time saying these things, but everybody was not happy. I spent all of Wednesday looking at screenshots and getting comments and messages on my opinion of Brandy and her lazy ass singing.
Oh my goodness.
And my dislike for Tupac. Like it wasn't even about my dislike for Tupac. It was about where he placed on
the
billboard.
So you know about this shit already?
No.
Oh man. It's bad.
And, I mean, I still stand by what I said. And there was a lot of people that agree with me too. So
But there were
a lot more people who didn't agree with me.
And you know, it was crazy. I thought I was going to catch hell last week, but it was you.
Nah, I was the bad girl, I guess. It's a few of y'all niggas I'm going to talk to at the end of the podcast.
No, you should get that shit off now.
Now?
Yeah.
Nah, I'm going to wait. I want to wait until I'm good and drunk.
Oh, okay. That'll get you going. Sorry, Ock.
Sorry. So you, Ant.
I'm tired, bro. It's been a long fucking week. I'm just tired, man. I've been shit working.
We're gonna turn this into a mental health podcast.
I ain't tired like no, niggas is tired from like working, you know, the music shit I've been doing, the wrestling podcast shit I've been doing too. It's just been like we did like damn near 2.5 hours on fucking Friday. You know,
I've been doing long ass podcasts lately.
Niggas just love to fucking talk, man. That's the problem, man. Like niggas be in there talking and shit. I was like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I be sitting there, I'm like, I'm tired of the motherfucker right now. Like niggas like midnight and shit. I'm like, fuck. So shout out to my nigga Larry. He showed up. And he's also gonna have my back when we have this Waka Flocka debate.
Oh god. I can't wait.
When is this shit supposed to happen?
So it's not gonna be his birthday episode, but it's gonna be the one after. Because Ant has been saying some wild shit about Waka Flocka saving hip hop.
Since we got a producer here, platinum selling producer. How do you feel about Waka Flocka and his contribution to hip hop? And went on board saying that he saved hip hop. What year we said? 2010?
How?
29, 2010. Change the sound. You changed the sound up. You know, I looked at it like, you know, because Wiz had a different sound and he switched over to when he did Drop Cabin Fever. That was the Waka sound that whole time. You know, he changed up, a lot of shit. Like, Ross had some of his biggest hits off that sound.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, when did Chief Keef come out?
That was 2012.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Mm. Well, you might have that.
Thank you. Thank you.
I don't, look, that was kind of like left field with Waka Flocka. I never thought about no shit like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I know. It was left field when
he
said
have
it.
Something.
Yeah. I be trying to... I tell people this shit. They looked at me like I was crazy.
Because you are fucking crazy.
People was like, you know, I agree with you on that shit.
Because the whole Lex Luger sound.
Yeah, that whole sound.
Damn. You may have something.
Thank you.
You may have something.
So you're saying he saved hip-hop because he changed the sound?
Yes, because it was boring. Like, it wasn't, like, shit just wasn't fun to me at that time, you know? I know it's like some shit came out there. They tried to bring up Take Care. Not Take Care. Thank Me Later. Mm-hmm. That was a boring-ass album to me.
It wasn't.
It was a boring. That was a boring album.
It's not Drake's best.
It's boring. It was boring. It was boring. Like, you know, around the time, like, because All Let's Do It dropped in 2009.
I feel like we should save this.
Yeah, okay, we'll save it. We'll save it. We'll save it.
It's going to be a whole fucking episode.
We'll save it. We'll save it.
Yeah.
We'll save it.
It's going to be a whole episode.
I'm glad somebody sort of agreed with me on this shit.
I will have to look and see all the albums that came out. You said 2009 that dropped. I will have to
2009, 2010, yeah.
But off the top of my head, I'm thinking about Kendrick. When did Kendrick come?
He was like 2012, too.
2012.
Yeah, 2012, too. Yeah.
Okay, you might.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
He might be on to something, real shit.
I have a nice little intro for that episode, too, by the way.
I bet you do. Damn. Lord Jesus. Anything else happened with y'all this week? Before we get into it.
I got a beat pack. I got a nice little beat pack.
Oh, that's what's up.
Yeah, from I'll tell y'all off here. I can't talk about it right now.
Oh, this nigga gonna bring it up.
Yeah. You can't talk about but you know, nice little beat pack is an opportunity.
I know,
there.
Right?
It's an opportunity there.
I already know what you was thinking.
Yeah, just everything's good. Oh. How about you, brother? How you doing?
I'm great as far as like sports wise. You know, my team won Super Bowl.
Oh. Is this your team or is this the favorite player?
My favorite player on my team. So.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Told y'all niggas, man.
Here we go.
I told y'all. I've been telling y'all.
Other than that, how you doing, brother?
Cool.
How's everything going?
I'm gonna be all right.
Mm-hmm. What? I do?
Nothing.
Come on now. You seen that look. Yeah, what I do now?
That was a death stare.
No, man. I was... It's been a funny week about the pod because with her, everything she's been going through.
Yeah.
It's been wild.
Yeah.
Good? Mm-hmm. Okay. All right.
How about you, brother? How you doing, man? How's your
week? I'm
great.
I'm great.
That's good.
Did you watch the Super Bowl?
Yeah.
Who'd you go for?
I didn't pick a team. I was, because I have a Discord. I do sports betting. So
gotcha.
I focused on player props.
Yeah, I'm on that same shit.
I didn't know.
I'm on that same shit.
You know, because it was just too much shit.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Even with Mahomes having the injury and then Hurts having his shoulder injury, I was just like, I don't know what's going to happen. So
yeah.
The fucked up part was I hit on basketball earlier that day. Like the football shit didn't do nothing for me. Like basketball, I'm straight.
I hit because I had Hurts for TD and the running back for KC, which is, I don't know how to pronounce his name right.
Pacheco.
Yeah, somebody threw up, like, somebody's like, put money on Hurts 3 touchdowns. I'm like, that shit ain't gonna happen. I look up, I'm like, what the fuck?
I was mad.
Thought about that. I'm like, man, I ain't gonna fuck with that shit. And I just looked up, I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
I could have been spread right there.
I swear I thought about that. Like, damn, I should have took that. I swear I was thinking about that.
Yeah.
Taking him for two, not three, but two.
Don't be looking at me like that, man.
I ain't think he was gonna ball out like that, though.
Because you're a dope fiend, fucking betting. Yeah.
I made a nice little bit amount of money off of that shit, man.
That shit fun.
Yeah, it's fun.
It's fine.
Y'all, y'all niggas be making me want to get into that shit.
It's live. It's live
stay
action.
Stay sober, Curt.
Just stay sober.
Just stay away
from this side over here, dog.
Get money, Curt.
Definitely get money, man, for sure. You're going to make a lot of motherfucking money, for sure. Yeah, yeah.
You just got to know how to bet.
Yeah, that's what it is.
So what bets did you place as far as like?
Super Bowl? I do player props. I do like a lot of player props. I do, you know what I'm saying, basketball. I do like threes, you know, assists and all that shit.
Y'all, All-Star game is tonight, isn't it?
Yeah, ain't shit.
I ain't fucking with that either.
I tried hockey this weekend. I'm like, nah, I had like a free $50 bet. I'm like, let me put some money on this hockey shit. Nah, I ain't hit.
I fuck with hockey.
Yeah, no, I do that. I hit on NASCAR though. I hit on NASCAR like a motherfucker. NASCAR is like a gold mine right there, boy. Like for real? Yeah, I won like about $2,000 off NASCAR.
Damn. Nigga.
This nigga be.
I gotta add you to the Discord.
Oh yeah, just let me know, man. Just let me know. I got you.
No, but it was a great Super Bowl though. I think it was one of the best. Mm-hmm. It lived up to the hype.
High scoring, two black quarterbacks out there. You know, Patrick Mahomes' dad came at the end. Like, ooh,
his dad is a nigga for sure.
Philly Blunts, sure. You know what I'm saying? Hell yeah. That nigga look like he fixed my alternator, nigga, with no problem.
Did y'all see that picture that leaked of the score, predicted score?
Yeah, I seen that bullshit.
Well, look, being that the score was, what, it was 35-37 or 35-38?
It was like 35-38, that's what it was.
35-38. It was close.
Yeah, it was close.
That shit had me like, bro, if this shit really happened, I'm
done. Hey, man, look, I have a saying, dog. I have this saying that I always say, everything is wrestling. Everything is scripted. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yeah, everything. Okay. I feel like
it's
everything
entertainment.
It's all entertainment. Yeah. Everything is scripted.
To some degree, it may not be like everything.
Everything,
yeah,
but like,
it's entertainment.
Well, yeah. Courtney, what's my man?
They
said
the NFL. They said that shit it's a script. Arian Foster.
Yeah, that shit was funny. He said niggas getting scripts and shit.
Yeah, yeah. And all that shit hit that picture and then him.
It all hit at the same time. They probably gonna kill that motherfucker. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Damn.
They might take that nigga out the game, bro. Like, he like, oh, you giving up too many secrets, motherfucker. So,
well, if he die, then we know what happened. It's hot than a motherfucker in here.
Yeah, that's
I just want to tell everybody.
Started drinking tequila
ass,
and shit.
Hold on.
I just want to tell everybody to kiss my ass. Fuck everybody, man.
You know what's fucked up, dog? You don't post anything on your social media, but you like, yeah, the Kansas City Chiefs did it, nigga. And I'm like, damn, nigga. I'm like,
I was rooting for the Chiefs all playoffs.
I mean, I feel you though, but like, you came out your spider cave and some shit like that, like, nigga.
That's
yeah,
what I do.
The Chiefs did it, nigga, and then went back in that shit.
Come alive right? In the nighttime.
Like, goddamn, boy.
I'm just happy that my nigga Mahomes got another Super Bowl.
Yeah, congratulations, boy.
You needed that, man.
This episode is.
That ain't it.
What the fuck
I'm going through this shit. I was trying to press.
No, this ain't the one at the career.
I was trying to press some claps for this nigga, man.
Don't touch shit.
Don't touch nothing.
Go to claps right there.
Shout out to my nigga Patrick Mahomes and all y'all other hating ass niggas. Kiss my ass because y'all kiss. Yeah, Eagles this, Eagles that. Fuck y'all. That's it.
I already did, boy. Hey, you know what I'm saying? I feel you.
Anyway, what y'all think about the halftime show?
I don't give a fuck.
So somebody was saying it was some significance about the what's the name it?
No.
It wasn't?
No.
You know what I was about to say?
Y'all niggas try to make something out of nothing. The 6 minutes, six songs, that shit. Is that what you're about to talk about?
No, they said all of the white dancers was the sperm and she was the egg. No.
What?
Yeah.
Nigga, I heard somebody talking about a tribute to Kanye.
No.
That's what I heard.
Y'all try to make something out of
she ain't doing
nothing.
No shit like that.
I mean, she was up there. She was probably, well, she wasn't high because she's pregnant, but you know. She was up there, you know, did her shit and got the fuck on.
Well, everybody was saying that she was the egg and all of the white dancers were the sperm and shit.
Did you talk to G about this shit?
This sounds like some shit he's been floating.
This
sounds
like some shit G was saying.
Yeah, I was like.
Damn, ASAP Rocky trying to secure that bag for life, my nigga. So how many kids you think, over and under, bet that, how many kids they going to have?
Shit, probably like three.
I was going to say three, too.
Yeah, probably like three.
So he can be a stay-at-home dad now. Man, technically, man. He is.
Can't act like my nigga ASAP won't get into the bag.
Exactly, dog. That nigga was getting money.
Yeah,
he's getting slid up in some billion-dollar coochie now, so it's a different story.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
I'm surprised. I'm not saying this shit. This shit is terrible.
Multiply, you know what I'm saying? So,
shout out to ASAP, man.
But, I mean, you know what I'm saying? It was a halftime show. Like, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? It was some white people that was like pissed off about it. Shout out Bill Goldberg because he said it was the worst one ever. You know what I'm saying? Bitch ass nigga. Like, give a fuck about you. But, you know, I mean, it was just a halftime performance. That's all it was. Like, they always been hit or miss. They always been hit or miss.
Yeah. You got a favorite?
Probably the one last year.
Yeah, that was lit.
Yeah, I fuck with that one. That one and then probably Michael Jackson.
Nigga, you was like two.
I watched it when I got older, motherfucker. So, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, hey, I like that one. You know what I'm saying? That's what YouTube is for.
Yeah, that's true.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Try to put me out there. I mean, I'm my bad, nigga. I'm not 45 like you, bro. So, you know.
I ain't 45 either, nigga. You can kiss my ass.
High school when that shit came out.
They got a high top fade back then too.
Anyway, PC, bro. What got you into producing, man? What producer stuck out when you were younger?
Man, I've been even before I actually started making beats on a beat machine. Like, I always been banging on my desk. Like, when I was in the second grade, I banged on the desk so much, my teacher made me sit in a corner with a headset, and I used to have to listen to classical music because I was to keep me from banging on my desk. So I always been making beats and shit.
Did you think the classical music though kind of helped you with your sound or whatever? No appreciation for the music.
I don't know. I was just born like this. But to answer your question, Dr. Dre, growing up, one of the first couple albums I could remember that really stuck to me was The Chronic and Doggy Style.
Oh, for sure.
So
he's more into the G-Funk.
Yeah.
Okay.
No. Yeah.
I mean, I was into everything, but
that's
G-Funk's definitely
that
shit.
My mom played that a lot, a whole lot. So
that's crazy. How old are you?
34, about to be 35.
All right.
Yeah.
Damn, my mom wasn't playing none of that shit in the house. Nigga, who was getting some Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes and shit? Man, wasn't no Dr. Dre. Who was my mom playing in the crib?
Janis Joplin.
Okay.
Fucking anything rock and roll, really.
Oh, that's dope. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You got any, besides Dre, you got any, a top five of producers that you feel like number one on your, a list? Because we've been doing lists like crazy. This has been coming like a list podcast.
We got another one coming up real soon.
Oh, my God. Goodness. I don't want to know about it.
Benny wants to stick out.
It's a lot of them. I ain't never really did top five. I could just tell you something that just for real, one of my favorite producers.
For sure. One of my favorites.
Dre, Manny Fresh.
Can't go wrong with Manny, man. Manny don't get enough credit, bro.
Nah. Lil Jon.
Yeah. I don't think he's enough credit.
He had simple beats, but if anybody was really listening, the mixing on his kick and his 808 was incredible.
Yeah, he overlooked for sure.
And Shorty Red.
Shorty Red, man. Mm-hmm. That's a good one.
Another one that don't get a lot of credit.
Yeah, for sure. Well, niggas took his sound and ran with it, but that's another story. But that's my nigga.
Oh, for sure, man. Yeah.
You guys did a song together, right?
Yeah, yep. I did something for Shorty Red on some random shit. Yeah.
What's the best, your favorite song you ever produced, though? Looking back, been so many. Got this nigga in the hot seat.
Buyout by Yo Gotti.
I fucked that.
Yeah, that was hard.
Yeah,
I really like that. I like what he was saying. I like the song. I like that a lot.
I wonder if we can play Yo Gotti on the pod.
Pull it up, nigga.
It's a mixtape song.
Yeah, it's mixtape. So yeah, go ahead and pull that shit up. That's not no problem.
No, I was just saying. Yeah, we can't play mixtape shit. This shit got me scared to play any fucking thing.
Nah, man.
Sorry, Jay.
Yeah, your favorite fucking rapper. Nigga.
Oh, why is it always him, though?
Because it's Jay-Z, nigga. That's why.
What the fuck, bro?
That nigga, he's a capitalist. He's gonna want to try to get everything he can. It's the truth. It's the truth.
Hold on.
Hey, so what store did you get this shit from?
I'm gonna tell you off air.
Okay.
I'm gonna tell you off air.
Oh, because
I'm gonna tell you off air. I got you.
The first time you brought that shit, I was like, yes. It's something there with that.
Cause she was telling me about you and your tequila taste and shit. Yeah. So I was like, I'm gonna help him out, man. Cause she was talking. She was talking shit about your tequila taste, by the way.
Huh?
Yeah. She was talking shit about it. He drink a bunch of trash. I'm like, damn, for real? I'm like, okay, I got him.
And it had you on some shit. No, bro.
So Don Julio.
Yeah, trash.
Primavera.
Mm-hmm.
That's trash.
Sorry.
Primavera.
It's all right.
Did you just start drinking that?
It's been I was drinking the heavy on my birthday. I think I was about a year. What else? It's this drink. When I was at Morton's one time.
Oh yeah, I love Morton's.
Somebody, I was asking a good drink. It's called a golden pineapple. It's Hennessy. Grant, what is it? Grand Marnier.
Grand Marnier, yep.
Pineapple juice. Bubble gum. The little syrup like shit.
Like a simple syrup, yeah.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And something else. That shit is great. Every time I go to like I go to Eddie V's a lot, and I had them because they don't have the drink. Like I told them what to do to make it.
See, niggas be calling me an old man because when I go to these places like this, I just get old fashioned. I fuck with old fashioned.
Give me some hands.
Yeah, yeah. Give me some old fashions, dog. Like I be telling niggas, dog, them bitches be on point, man, for real. But nah, like I'm gonna put you on some shit though. I'm gonna off air. I'm gonna put you on a bunch of different tequila and shit because she was really just like, you need to help him.
I did not make it sound that bad.
Yeah, I mean, you kind of did, man.
I did not.
Asja, how did you and PC meet, though?
We had a ton of mutual friends, other producers, rappers. Fab has been a good friend of mine since, like, 2007, 2008. Mm-hmm. And they were all in the Olympics together.
Yep. The hangout spot was the fucking Dante Loft, where he used to do the... $10
photo shoots
every year. He used to be, I remember her from there for sure.
Yeah, it was, he used to have a lot of parties. So I was almost at every fucking party. Me and Yasmin that I brought to the podcast.
Oh, yeah, Yasmin, shout out to her.
We used to open and close that bitch down.
Look at you. Open and close.
Back in my day.
I know, right?
Right.
God damn, man. That was a long time ago. Yeah.
That was like 11 years ago.
Was it that? Yeah, 2000. Hell
yeah.
Yeah.
Feel so fucking
old.
No,
it was more than 11 years ago. See, this actually, yeah.
11, 12.
Yeah, I feel so old right now.
I know.
Shit. I'm about to be 36 on Sunday.
That's wild.
Yeah, this shit's so hard, dog. Cause
this my life, nigga. You know what I'm saying? This is shit I'm going through. The state
Yo,
of
Gotti been on
the
hell
day,
of a run, though. His last few projects been amazing. He say he retired. That nigga retired. All
right. You put a little delay on it from here.
Shit, he can retire if he wants to. Shit.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Don't erase none of that shit. That's the intro. We're keeping it like that. 100 miles of running, niggas gunning at the end of me. Niggas switching sides, giving up like it's the end of me. Niggas all in family, but I know these niggas envy me. Pound heat thugging to the motherfucker, sin is me. I'm a trending topic.
God damn, I don't know how to fucking work this shit no more.
Rusty still.
Dog, I need to get it together, man.
It's all good. It's all good. But nah, I definitely remember that shit. Which mixtape that was off of?
The World Is Yours.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, that was a hard project.
What else happened this week, though, Ant? What happened to your boy?
My boy who?
The GOAT, Ray J.
Oh, him and Raz B had that squabble. You know what I'm saying? They was hugging each other and shit. There wasn't no really fighting or nothing like that. Niggas was hugging each other.
What is that shit all about, though?
About a show that they both executive producing. I guess
oh, it's burning up in this bitch.
Yeah,
open that door.
I'm sweating. Open that door. I ain't a sweaty type. Yeah,
open that door, please.
That tequila.
Yeah,
yeah. I'm sweating.
Please. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, nah.
Trying to kill us up in this motherfucker.
Them niggas was wrestling and shit. I guess they was mad about. Ray J was mad because Raz B wanted to have like a lot more fighting on their show, and Ray J was like, "I'm trying to promote peace" or some shit like that. So. Some niggas had an argument about that shit and they fought in the club. Well, they wrestled in the club. They didn't fight because there was no punches thrown up like that.
Because I'm sure they weren't trying to hurt each other for real.
I don't know, man. Ray J be boo-bopping niggas, dog.
I'm sorry. What did you call it?
Ray J be boo-bopping niggas.
Boo-bopping? What the fuck is that?
Just punch the shit out of you. Yeah, boo-bop. Thank you. You know what I'm saying? So just...
We call it Molly Watt.
I'm going by West Coast. Swing.
I'm getting calls from WAC 100. Niggas is questioning my manhood, talking about Ray J fading me. Listen, Ray, you my brother, I respect you, we business partners, but nigga, guess what? I gotta catch this motherfucking fade, nigga. Real talk, nigga. Fuck the fight, I don't give a fuck if two people show up, nigga. I don't give a fuck if it's two views, nigga. Shit, it may be 1,000 people, shit. If you get your sister to sing the national anthem, you always gonna be Brandy's little brother, nigga. Nigga, I stand alone, nigga.
What's wrong with this nigga, man?
The thing we need to understand about Raz B is the agent of chaos, dog.
That nigga sound like he smoked crack.
You think so?
Hey, Raz B is the fucking agent of chaos. Yes. Hell yeah, he is.
Do tell.
I mean, look how he be acting. You know what I'm saying? That nigga always, he's ready to fight all the time.
It's these R&B niggas, like these group niggas.
They crazy.
Like, even Pretty Ricky. Them, like, all these niggas are.
Didn't Baby Blue just get out?
Yeah, Baby Blue just got out. Pleasure Pete, well, he didn't get beat up by Tony Yayo, but niggas said he got beat up by Tony Yayo, but it didn't happen.
How the fuck would he get beat
That's
up
That's so
by
random.
That is random.
Tycoon Weekend with 50. So.
Man, it'd be like some shit going down with that Tycoon Weekend shit with 50, bro.
Trey Songz got banned from that shit. I mean, you know, just the R&B niggas, man. They trying to prove that they tough. There's been a lot of R&B niggas here in the city, too. That
Who's the toughest R&B niggas you think?
Damn. That's a good question.
Trey Songz.
Nate Dogg for sure. Hell yeah. Nate Dogg. 100% is Nate Dogg. But really, outside of him, Trey Songz.
It's definitely Trey Songz.
Yeah, because Trey Songz.
That nigga Trey Songz, that nigga be on some wild.
Yeah, that nigga really be beating people the fuck up.
That's crazy.
You seen that video when he was singing back in the day and shit.
What?
That terrible ass song.
I know you got that
He
shit.
Was a hood nigga, and they tried to clean him up and make him an R&B singer.
Nigga, he went from selling drugs, welcome to the ghost town and shit, just got to make it. In a year. They're like, we going to sign you, nigga, but we got to get you off of that shit.
It's obvious now. Like, when you look at the track record of old songs, it's like, oh, yeah, they definitely was like, nigga, we going to clean you up and sign you.
Man, they cleaned that nigga the fuck up quick, dog. I don't even feel like looking for that shit, man. But that nigga was like some song called Genia Boy, nigga. Some nigga that had
that
it.
Shit was terrible.
No, this nigga. Let me tell you about this Genia Boy track. So this nigga had the fit on, right? Mm-hmm. With this one nigga that was rapping and she had the fit on and everything. Mm-hmm. He was in the Just Gotta Make It video with the same fucking fit on.
Are you serious?
I bullshit you not.
Yeah, I gotta see this.
Okay, one. I'll show you. I'll show you.
You one of them niggas that be researching shit.
Yeah, I do.
And I'll leave you down a rabbit hole. Come with facts, yeah, videos, dates, right. Times, years.
I think you research more than I do.
I probably
you be doing the most random ass shit.
Yeah, that was random.
Yeah.
So
I probably do. I probably do, man. I ain't gonna lie to you, dog. Cause I was watching the video. I'm like, I'm just telling me, like, watch the video over again. And then I seen this nigga named Mumit Daddy. He over there cutting some nigga hair with the same shirt on.
Mumit
chain.
Daddy.
Yeah.
Who the fuck is that?
That's the nigga that's rapping on the song with Trey Songz.
His name is Monique Daddy.
Mumit Daddy.
Mumit.
Mumit. I don't know.
You struggling.
I don't know. I don't know, bro.
Dog. All right.
Yeah, them niggas, man, them niggas had a King of Virginia mixtape, all type of shit, man. It was just, it's wild.
Because Trey originally was supposed to be a rapper, right?
I don't even fucking know. That nigga was just on that bitch
he
singing,
says
dog.
That,
yeah, no, that nigga was no. When I seen that video, when that nigga had two watches on and shit with a corner store tee, that nigga was singing. That nigga was singing, bro.
Dog,
hold on, I'm about to find that shit. No,
please find that shit.
Yeah, give me a minute.
This goes back to the bar and grill shit, like.
Oh, she was so mad about that shit too.
Oh, because about the Lil Wayne shit.
Yeah. That nigga was not performing at fucking Applebee's.
Man, that nigga went on the street, dog, performing at these fucking bar and grills.
Nah, he was on the street. Nah, come on, and
he went on the street, nigga. That nigga, when him and Birdman was beefing, dog, that nigga went on the street. He was just performing at bar and grills.
He was, but don't say Applebee's. Applebee's makes it. No, don't put that nigga that low. It's a terrible song. It's a terrible song.
That nigga was some shit.
He was on
some shit. Watching my daddy. That nigga was singing to try to get out the fucking hood, man. I respect that
shit. That's why his first album was called Just Gotta Make It.
Hell yeah, because he had to fucking make it. Like, did you see what the fuck he was wearing? That nigga was struggling. He like, I gotta get up. I gotta get about this shit.
Terrible.
That nigga had a song called Ghost. She heard that shit. The song Ghost Town.
That shit. I didn't even believe it was him on the song. Like, I was.
And then that nigga to the end. I would like to welcome you, Petersburg, Virginia. Nigga was singing like a. Them niggas in that bitch struggling though. I respect it, but yeah, Trey Songz definitely was beating niggas the fuck up.
Oh my god.
That's crazy.
Trey Songz, definitely Nate Dogg. I mean, we seen a golf. We seen a.
Oh,
golf
for
course.
Sure.
We seen the golf course.
Oh, for sure.
No, a lot of these R&B niggas really. Aaron Hall.
Bobby Brown. Aaron Hall. I miss you.
Yeah. That nigga's a motherfucker.
Hey, man. I hated that song.
I hated it too.
Yeah, I hated that video.
I hated it too.
That video was depressing as fuck.
Yes. Bro. That shit gave me PTSD as a young nigga. And that's random as fuck. That's crazy you said that. I remember that song. Yeah, I remember that video.
Yeah, like, bro, you had to die, though.
Yeah. Bro. That shit gave me PTSD.
Yeah,
for
I hate
sure.
that fucking
I hated
song,
that song, bro. All right, turn that shit off. For real. God damn.
You know what video scared me as a kid?
What?
Crossroads by Bone Thug, dog.
We're not about to do that shit. We're not about to.
That shit used to scare me as a kid, dog.
I'm mad you just said that because I'm going to think about that before I go to sleep.
Nigga, Uncle Charles.
And dog probably going to. Yeah,
nigga, Uncle Charles. Uncle Charles the fuck up out of here. That's fucked up, man.
Yeah.
I seen that black nigga in the trench coat like 2 weeks ago.
The fuck is you going through, nigga? You all right?
No, there's a nigga walking
Tupac
around.
Tupac at the
Rock Nation brunch.
Who? Huh?
Curt Tupac was at the. He was not. He wasn't there, nigga. He's
I mean, did
alive.
You see Anthony Mackie bald headed? Maybe that might have been him. You know what I'm saying?
Hell no, that was the worst Tupac of all time, bro.
It was.
What's up, this Tupac?
Check it out, motherfucker. I'm Tupac.
Terrible, oh my man. God.
That was my
that
shit.
That was terrible.
Why they got that nigga to do that shit, bro?
Budget. You know, the budget was.
What's the
shit?
Other nigga that played Tupac? The one that actually looked like that nigga, though.
Oh, that young dude.
Tupac. Just name the boy, the guy that looked like Tupac.
I can't think of
it. Oh, I can't remember his
name. He fucked some shit up because he, like, got accused of rape or some shit. Which is coincidental.
Well, there it is.
His career was taken off. That nigga fucked up, and he was like sexual assaulting like castmates or some shit.
No, that's that nigga that played Eazy-E. That nigga that played Eazy-E.
Oh,
yeah, that was that nigga.
Okay.
Yeah, it was that nigga.
He got kicked off the shot.
Yeah, he got kicked. They killed that nigga off camera, nigga.
And
that's how you know you fucked up.
And killed the series because that shit ain't been good since.
Lena Waithe fucked a lot of that shit.
It was cool.
It's decent. But
cool.
It ain't as good as the first two seasons.
Nah, no.
Because they built the character around his character. I mean, built the show around his character.
Mm.
And then they had to, like, scramble to find some, like, put some pieces and shit together. That shit.
But that the season when old girl got kidnapped,
mm-hmm.
That was wild.
Yeah, that was a wild scene. Man, that
was
the
a hell
whole
of a plot twist.
Yeah, what's that, like, season four?
Yeah.
I think. How long that shit been on? It's about to be season six coming up, right?
Jesus Christ.
I don't know. Five or six. Y'all got any shows y'all currently watching right now?
Mm-hmm. I'm about to start off Snowfall.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, Snowfall this week.
PC, what you been watching?
What the fuck is it called? My man's from Breaking Bad. I can't think of the name. It's on top of my head.
Your Honor.
Your Honor.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Your Honor.
You like that show?
Godfather of Harlem.
Mm-hmm.
BMF, of course.
Of course.
Yeah. Of course.
Yeah. How y'all feel about this season, though?
Shout out to my girl, Brittany F. She was in the show.
No work.
The girl that raps?
Yeah, she like an extra in there, but you know, she showed up.
That's what's up.
Yeah, shout out to her.
Show going all over the place though this season.
Shout out to Charles, by the way. Nigga Charles been on there wilding, dog.
I ain't seen the latest episode,
yeah,
though.
Man, I don't know, man. I ain't gonna say too much, man. But yeah, she put them long titties on his back, man. Changed his whole life up for real. What up, though? All right,
I'm not gonna say shit.
We ain't gonna do it. You know, we ain't gonna do a last episode.
How the fuck I'm not closing the door?
We ain't gonna do a last episode. I remember what you said last episode.
No, yeah. Asia, I need you to speak up for yourself. Defend yourself, nigga.
I will.
You gonna wait? She wanna drink more. Just give her time.
Give her time. I'm straight.
I ain't like the way people was talking about you last week.
You didn't. Mm-mm. Oh, that means something to me.
Yeah.
I know.
I'm an asshole, but on the show.
They not allowed to be assholes?
No, only me and Aunt. You know.
Yeah.
We natural assholes.
Nah, but we got you. So whenever you're ready, we got you.
Yeah.
What do you mean whenever I'm ready? Like, I'm not recovering from trauma.
Nigga, to the end of the show, man. That's what I'm talking about.
Here's, okay. Let's unpack a little bit. Yeah. What was this nigga named? Tristan?
Yeah, Tristan Knight.
Okay.
Tristan Hudson, yeah. Acapella.
Here we go, Tristan.
Shout out to my nigga Tristan, too.
Several people, including Aunt, was like, you gotta get this nigga together. Because I come off as a sweetheart. I am a sweetheart. But I have a mouth on me. And I definitely wanted to say something and tear this nigga life down via podcast. But I'm like, you know what, this nigga married. He got a kid. I couldn't do that. I respect shit like that. Mm-hmm. However.
Oh, shit. I didn't think it was going to be smoke towards him.
he was disrespectful as fuck. He like, man, tell old girl, nigga. Like, yeah, I was like, ah,
that's
shit.
The part who fucked me the most. Ah, okay, like, nigga, I'm not a fucking guest on a fucking podcast. You hear my name at least 3-4 times every fucking episode. I'm on every fucking episode. Nigga, this is a partnership and it's a network. So the fact that you address me as old girl, you got me fucked up. Because I know you listening. So come on now. You know my name. You know how to spell it. Just say it. And you think that was the most Angela-y-ish shit I could have said? Like,
oh, damn. I can't even air horns.
Look at
it.
I see you tapping away, but I didn't need it.
That was a cowbell that you just hit by mistake. That shit said, bang.
Give me more cowbell.
Damn.
One thing is, I got a lot of nicknames. You can call me Mirror. You can call me Miracle. You can call me Asja. You can call me Age. But, like, nigga, address me by my name. As Aunt would say, make my shit straight, bitch ass nigga. Like, say my shit right.
Oh, shit.
So that's damn. All I got to say to Tristan. That's it.
Shout
out
to Tristan, though. My bad, bro. I didn't think she was going
to blame you. I thought she was going to flip. Shout out to Tizzy, too, because he was egging that shit on, too. Like, man,
he was.
You got to say something to her, bro.
That's it. That's all I got to say. And who the fuck said that about me having, like, I sound like the Rick Ross intro?
My nigga Wood. My nigga Woody. He a big fan of the show. He listen every week.
He not lying.
You do. Maybach music.
Oh, shit.
See, y'all didn't even put it together.
I'm like, yeah, I will not even say, I'm like, where are they going with this?
Yeah. Damn, that's crazy.
So, PC.
So, that was it.
What you been working on, bro? You got some new shit you working on?
All type of shit.
What's going on?
I just opened up a game room, an esports facility in Livonia, Michigan.
For real? Where is it?
Huh?
Where is it?
It's in Laurel Park Place Mall.
Oh, yeah. I was just over there.
Yeah, yeah. We just did the soft opening Friday. We waiting on the sign to get put up to do the grand opening, but that's like the main thing I'm working on right now outside of Courtney. My artist, Courtney Bell, his album is done.
Dope artist.
Yeah, appreciate that.
Super dope.
I'm co-executive producing his project with Royce da 5'9", which is an honor, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm excited about that. And I got other stuff going on. I'm in the trucking. I got a box truck, Sprinter, all different type of shit. But my main things is the game room and Courtney. Dope. Yep. So
when you doing the grand opening?
As soon as we get the sign up, we just waiting on the city to come and give us our certification, and then Signorama just gonna throw it up there. So
shit, let
it
me
should
know.
Be, it yeah, should be within like the next week or two. But we we did the soft opening Friday. Like I said, we just opened the doors for the mall
because
corporate was on my head. But we having an event on where this guy came and booked. He having an event on March the 3rd on a Friday. It's like a retro fighting games tournament. So that's going to be dope.
Okay.
But other than that, yeah, we'll be doing the grand opening within the next month.
That's hard.
Okay, yeah.
So, yeah, but yeah. I'm real excited about that. I game crazy, so.
Shit, what you playing right now?
Warzone.
Everybody on Warzone.
That's
bro.
All I play.
Everybody on Warzone.
I was
man.
Heavy on Madden, but Warzone just changed that. Like, I don't play shit up.
Shit, right now I've been stuck on fire. I just beat God of War 2.
Okay, I heard about
just,
that.
Just finished that shit. Okay. 28th, I'm about to jump back on Destiny.
Okay.
That's been like, I've been playing that shit like 2013, 2014 or some shit. Like
okay, that. That's something that we got downloaded because we got like Destiny.
Yep.
Warzone,
okay.
Fortnite,
okay.
Apex,
okay.
League of Legends. Mm-hmm. Like, that's all, like, on our
PCs.
Damn,
I might have to bring my student.
Yeah, definitely League of Legends, for sure. Yeah. They love that shit. Damn, another one I want to suggest to you, Rocket League.
Rocket League. That's on a couple. So, we got, so it's 28 stations. We got, like Rocket League is on a couple Xboxes off the top of my head.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm just thinking about the PCs. Another one, it started with a V.
Valorant.
Valorant.
That shit still going?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yup. Valorant and something else. You looking
like. Yeah, they both looking like, what the fuck are you talking about, nigga?
No, I'm
no, we I'm, game, like, nah, I'm a gamer. Nah, I'm a gamer like a motherfucker, man. Like, you know, like, I don't know. Do you play single player shit like Elden Ring and all that?
No, man. I only play Warzone.
Yeah, Warzone. Yeah,
I used to play other shit, but Warzone just
man, my shit,
my
man,
life.
My
so.
Shit been GTA Online, dog.
We got GTA with the you know everybody want to play on the TV server and all that shit.
Nah, like nigga, like I don't do them servers and none of that shit. I just do it strictly the GTA Online and shit.
Okay,
like nigga, we be on some bullshit on that one, boy. I tell you, like,
okay,
nigga, me, my nigga, Stack, Hunted. My nigga, like, we just all be on some bullshit with
the
that.
Whole bougie crew.
Yeah, you can say that. the niggas that pop shrooms, you right?
Oh shit, man! Courtney, the shroom guy.
Oh,
so
man,
I know all about the shrooms.
I got a story about that.
I never did.
I know a story she about to tell you. But yeah, it was a wild ass story because
The shroom story.
We'll tell you off air. Shout out to G too, because G was fighting for his fucking life last night. That nigga took shrooms last night and shit.
Oh, man.
Nigga took shrimp's drunk an energy drink. I'm like, what
everybody.
The fuck is you doing? That nigga was tripping, dog.
That shit ain't fair.
That nigga took shrooms, took an energy drink. I'm like, gee, what are you doing, bro?
Oh, man.
It's terrible.
That nigga wild.
Yeah, man. That's my nigga, though, man. Fuck.
So, outside of Courtney Bell, do you plan on taking on any more artists?
That's a good question. Yeah, when it comes to me, I'm not looking for other artists. Like, if it come, it come. But I'm not just on Instagram. Like, damn, I need to find new artists or anything like that. Like, I'm focused on Courtney.
A female artist or nothing like that?
No, I'm focused on Courtney. If it comes, it comes, but I'm not looking. But if I see some dope shit, then because I wasn't like looking for Courtney per se. Like, I had one on the when I had produced the singles for Jeezy Pressure album. Uh-huh. I had did an interview with the radio station, and they had asked me what would it take for like independent artists to get beats from me, and I'm like, it ain't about the money. If you got talent and you serious about your craft, I'm willing to work. So after I got off the radio, I had like 300 DMs, literally. And I went through all of them. I looked at every DM. Uh-huh. And Ray, which is Courtney manager, he had sent me a DM, and it was just what he was saying. Like, I'm like, damn, I'm a looking to do, you know what I'm saying, looking to do artists or whatever, because he was like kind of professional with the shit.
Right.
So I talked to him, and when I talked to him on the phone, he was professional, like, yeah, man, we just trying to work with you, whatever the fuck he said. I don't remember word from word what he said, but I spent him, not on purpose, but I was just doing a lot of shit. I spent him, and then he was on it. Like, he was like, yo, we trying to get with you. I'm like, bet, you know what, come to the studio. And they came, and Courtney and him came to the studio, and that nigga played me 3 albums and like 15 videos that was unreleased. And I was blew away by the shit because it was, like, different.
You don't see that from a lot of artists.
Yeah.
You know? Sure don't.
Yeah, like, that. Like, he had a lot of shit. And I'm like, and he was dope. And it was different. And that's what catches my ear. Like, anybody asks me, like, what you looking for? Different. Like, something that I haven't heard before. Like, not to say, like, it can't sound like something else.
Right.
But it's just got to have a twist on it because everybody inspired by some other artist. But he was different, and I was just blown away, and then the rest is history.
Is there any artists out there, though, that you wish you could produce for? Like, what artists, like, stand out?
Like, new or just period?
New?
Any new
artist? Yeah, it could be new.
Baby Keem.
Okay.
I like Baby Keem. I can definitely see that.
Yeah, he slept on, bro. That motherfucking talented.
Yeah, he showed out on that Kendrick album.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And his shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, his album's cool too.
Yeah, that album is dope.
Oh, what I was going to ask was, so Courtney's sound when he first came to you was a little different than what he's doing now.
Yeah.
How do you feel about it?
I feel great about it because it's real. Because when I met him, he was going through a spiritual journey, as you would say. And I'm not going to say he got out of it, but certain things changed, and I questioned it, like, yo, I thought you was on this, what the fuck? And kept it 100, like, yo, X, Y, and Z happened, this happened, you know what I'm saying? And I'm on this, like, I seen this, and now I'm on this. Like, it all makes sense. I don't want to get too much away because his next project kind of, like, explained that because a lot of people was, like, confused.
Yeah.
But it's real shit, like, him as a man, him as a young man, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're trying to find yourself and you just going through the motions. So I feel like that's what it is with him. But this album is like explaining all that shit. And it's like two sides. You know what I'm saying? Because he is with, like, his mom and his dad is his mom and his dad. He come from where he come from. Mm-hmm. But he found himself in something. But he can't change who he is. So it's like two sides to it. You know what I mean? Like duality. So it makes sense. Like when the next album come out, the title of it, the topics, like everything, you'll understand.
When y'all expecting to drop it?
Spring, summer. It's done. We just did a new partnership with Monarch. Shout out to JY. We just figuring out like all the stuff that's around it as far as getting videos done, rollout, all that stuff. But the body of work is completely done. It's incredible. I put my career on the line for this project.
That's big.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this shit is dope. Damn. For real.
So like, how do you feel about working with Royce? Because
man, it's a blessing. It's a blessing. Royce is a cool nigga, man.
Yeah, because I met Royce like years ago when I heard Layers. Because Asar, he took me to me and Asar went to Royce studio. We listened to Layers, and he played the Slaughterhouse album.
Oh, dope! And
you heard that album?
Yeah.
And Glass House, that bitch is crazy, dog. So I met Royce, cool, very cool motherfucking.
Yeah,
what I'm
he a cool nigga, man. He gives us a lot of wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he tell us all his experience because he see himself in Courtney. That's why they connect. So
that's the big thing about Royce, though. He always, you know. Cause then always say like old school. I ain't gonna say old school rappers, but older rappers don't really be looking out for the people that's on the come up though.
He's probably one of the main ones.
He's like one
shit.
Of the main ones that be like real, you know, intricate and don't mind, you know, reaching out to the younger artists and putting them on, you know. So that's dope.
Deb Anthony addressed that in her interview is that like there's no older rappers taking new rappers up under their wings. Like,
why is that? Y'all think?
Shit, they still try. They still
it's
chasing
a generational
something.
Thing.
They still chasing something. You know what
exactly.
I'm saying?
Yeah, they don't know. Yeah.
I think it boils down to what we were talking about: is that you don't really want somebody that you take under your wing to be bigger than you.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. And they chase it like all that.
I don't know what I was thinking about the whole Kareem and LeBron thing, but
I mean,
that's prime. You seen this old bitch ass over there, mad as hell and shit.
Jesus Christ.
He was mad at the motherfucker. That nigga was sitting there like he was in disgust. Like, nigga, why am I here?
It was past his bedtime.
Man, look, when he gave LeBron that ball, all that celebration, that man went back, got a vodka and cranberry. Nigga was drinking that bitch out of straw, nigga. He did not want to be there.
They had that picture with how he looked when he hit the shot.
Yeah. That bitch was my profile picture for sure.
That nigga was mad.
He couldn't, yeah, because even Magic said like he's not gonna be happy about this shit, and he was not happy about that shit.
Bro, I don't give a fuck.
Nigga, it's 40 years later.
Yeah, it's 40 years later. So, but it's old ass. Like, man, you know these old. You know, I'm not even gonna get into it.
Yeah, don't please.
I'm not even gonna get into it. Because I was gonna say some shit, man. I was gonna have a lot of old niggas at my door like a free throw, nigga. Like, what you doing? I ain't gonna say nothing.
Man. Yeah. How would you feel though? Somebody broke a record that you did though?
I'd probably be mad. I'd be mad. Like,
you
damn.
A little salty.
Hell yeah, I'd be salty. Like, damn, nigga. Like, I didn't think that shit was gonna happen. Like, Kareem didn't think that shit was gonna happen.
Nobody thought that was gonna happen.
And it happened. And it happened to a nigga he don't really care for. That's the thing. He don't like LeBron.
What do you think is his issue with LeBron?
LeBron stands on social justice.
He was doing the same though, but it was different times back.
He think LeBron is grandstanding.
Niggas was actually like lynching.
He think LeBron was grandstanding a lot of shit. That's why. Mm. So that's where that whole shit come from.
I know he ain't got no love for Kyrie. Shitting on him too.
Yeah.
What you about to say? What?
Yeah, I think they kind of share the same values. A little bit.
Kyrie a little out there though.
I mean, he's a flat earther. So.
Are you a flat earther?
Fuck no.
I met one.
I think I know who you're talking about too.
I didn't think them niggas existed.
No, them niggas are for real.
Like when he tried, he told me without telling me that he believed that the earth was flat, and I was like, "Oh shit!" I was like, "I didn't think y'all existed for real." Like in real life, met somebody that thought the earth like strongly and tried to plead his case that the earth was flat. And I was like, oh, nah. I'm a conspiracy theorist, but not on that level.
You're a conspiracy theorist?
Mm.
You think
Shut
so?
Up, Ant. Shut up. Yes, I am.
Why y'all ain't never had her on the show?
Because she don't want to be on there.
I don't want to be put in
that
bubble.
You got a conspiracy show?
It's called, it's called What the Fuck Did I Miss?
This nigga got like 18 like, yeah,
I thought you were about to say, what the fuck is going on?
No, it's called What the Fuck.
You a genius.
We thought about that, but we used What the Fuck Did I Miss? Because we talked about a lot of shit that people ain't up on. Mm. Like our first episode, we talked about Jeffrey Epstein and all that shit. And then like maybe a couple of weeks later, that's when that shit blew up.
That further lets me know that you be studying and researching some shit.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
That's called.
It sounds like you be on that same type of time too.
Semi.
Yeah.
Okay,
we gonna talk. Semi. We gonna talk. Cause yeah, I be on all that shit. Like I blame G for the coronavirus because we had an episode called Coronavirus and he kept saying on the show, Coronavirus. So he kept saying that shit.
Out of nowhere.
And then like a week later he come Gretch on like, yeah, we shutting everything down. I'm like, fuck.
Yeah. G low key a prophet though.
He is.
Don't get that nigga that much. Please don't get that nigga that much power. Please don't.
Shit.
Man, we got
proof is in the pudding.
Yeah, that nigga be on some shit. That nigga be on some shit for real.
Nothing.
We bringing the show back, man. So if you ever want to come on, man, you know.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Y'all gonna bring that back, I'm with whatever.
I'll be looking at April. We're gonna bring it back in April. Talk to Don. G said he ready whenever. So we're gonna do it in April.
Oh, it's gonna be like monthly.
We're gonna do a monthly show.
I told them they need to come back at least two fucking episodes.
It just depends on G. That's what it is. Cause
that nigga ain't that busy.
Man, shit.
He ain't busier than me.
Shit.
Nobody's busier than you.
I don't fucking know. This nigga G got like three or four different fucking jobs, dog.
Okay, I'm gonna talk to Soy.
Damn, you just have to.
We gonna freeze him. That nigga need to be here too. We gotta make all the podcasts. You know, we gotta make this shit great.
Yeah, you know, shout out to Game Day Club. They got their theme song now. Shout out to Train for putting that together for them.
Yeah.
So that nigga gonna be the fucking theme song king. Oh, that was Tizzy.
That was Tizzy. Yeah. Train got two of them. He got one for Mick Harder's too.
Ooh,
so.
I gotta hear what Train did.
I'll play for you off
air. He does some shit.
I'll play for you off air.
I'm still
recording. Hey, that tequila is really good.
Hey.
See? I was looking at him the whole time.
No bullshit.
Yeah. He having the time. See,
I'm gonna tell you.
And I feel good.
I'm gonna put you on some shit. A lot of these tequilas, like Don Julio and Patron,
they're not stepped good
on.
Tequila.
They stepped on. They're like nigga, like some of they.
And this is uncut.
This is uncut.
Okay. Yeah, because this shit got me feeling good.
Yeah, it's uncut like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
It's the Franklin Saint of tequila.
Damn.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
That's
so
good. You do be knowing some shit, bro.
Yeah. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
You need to start. I have a YouTube channel just dedicated to reviewing different.
Oh, it is what it is. I ain't telling where we got it from though. So it is what it is. We are on camera, but I ain't telling where we got it from though. So it don't even fucking matter. But
where y'all got that from?
Yeah, I'm gonna tell you off air.
Man, okay,
I ain't telling on there. Y'all not getting this shit. Y'all not getting this shit. I don't give a fuck. The camera is on me, motherfucker. So yeah.
The camera on me.
Use your common sense. So let me ask you this, bro. When you feeling down, like you don't feel like doing shit, like producer or anything like that, what brings you out to like, you know, what inspires you to get back into it?
Music or what inspires me to get back into music. Yeah. I mean, to
producing. Yeah, producing and everything. Like, you know, we all, niggas have that slump when they don't feel like doing shit. You know, they have a block or anything. Like,
that was like the biggest thing with me being focused on being an executive producer opposed to being a producer.
Mm-hmm.
I just love making beats. I love making beats. The thing that kind of took me away from it was like on the business side of it, like just what I was going through. Like, from me departing from the Olympics in 2012 or 11, I forget. I didn't get a placement until 2015.
What was that placement?
So I Let Them Know by Jeezy on the Trap Without 3 album.
Amazing.
That was you?
And you make fun of me for loving that album, but I love
I didn't make fun of you for loving that. I love that album. I ain't make fun of you for loving that album.
That's crazy because I
come on, man. I never made
I'm
fun
on
of
camera,
you
so I shouldn't be saying it, but I don't.
You know, she did tell me that. She did tell me that.
You love that album. That's a friend.
I do.
Damn.
She did tell me that.
But, I do because I made a lot of money off of it. But
for sure.
As far as like what, like, man, I'm a, like, Trap or Die 2 was my shit.
Man,
the mixtape, man. My favorite, my God, that was a no skip.
Man, my favorite track on that bitch was Going Crazy.
Going Crazy, okay.
That was my shit,
okay.
Dog. That is a good Okay. That was a good song.
That's probably the only song I can
remember. It was. I don't even have a favorite because I love so many different songs.
That whole project was so crazy, dog. Because when he said "Trapper Dad" too, I'm like, man, I don't know, dog. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he dropped that bitch. I'm like, oh
those
shit.
Those expectations of the first
one. Yeah, man.
Yeah, but to answer your question, yeah, just me, just making me. Like I love to make music. It's just like the way my life is set up now. I really don't on some real shit. I don't be having no time or like. If I sit in my, because I got my studio in my house now.
Yeah.
And when I sit in the studio and just try to like focus and make beats, I get anxiety because I be having so much shit that I could be doing.
Mm-hmm.
And that I have on the floor that's real, like real bills. Like, you know, like with the game room, like my overhead is like our overhead. I got partners. It's crazy. So me sitting still, it gives me anxiety. Like, oh shit!
Yeah,
I need to be doing this. I need to be doing that. I need to be doing that. You know what I'm saying? So
it's like I feel you on that shit because it's hard for me to sit down and write something or something like that because I'd just be sitting there like, damn, I got this shit going on. I got this shit going on. Like it's hard to like just put your focus into that shit and like, damn, you know what I'm saying? Like every day is just crumbling around you right now, and it's like, damn, what the fuck is next? You know? Yeah.
Now when it come to Courtney, even though I didn't produce anything on this project that's coming out by choice.
Why is that?
Because I just really wanted to focus. Huh?
Just want
to
be more.
Yeah, and the last album we put out, Poverty Stricken, which was put out, what people don't know, it was put out under Sony RCA. Courtney was signed to RCA, and we parted ways from them. Like, we was going to announce it after Poverty Stricken, but we ended up parting ways. But I produced that whole album pretty much. Uh-huh. But I just wanted to I just wanted to this next album be a success and me focus on everything else, focus on being the executive producer, so focus on overseeing everything from videos to the budget to the mixing, the track listing, everything outside of just making a damn beat, you know what I mean? And I found the new passion just in general for that. Because, like, it could be a fucking picture Courtney post, and he hit me like, yo, bro, what should I say? And I give him advice like, you should come like this. Or it might be, like, a trailer for a video, and I'm like, yo, post this part of it. Uh-huh. And then he do it, and then everybody going crazy.
Yeah.
And it give me a rush. The same way it would if I made a beat for somebody, and everybody like, oh, this shit cold. It's just a new thing, you know what I mean?
And
so,
that's right. A big thing too. It's like content is king. You gotta make sure
exactly.
That
so when people there, like, man. I got a lot of homeboys, a lot of producer homeboys. Like, say for instance, like Ant Beats. Like, I had talked to him. We was in New York, and I had told him this shit. Like, man, I'm focused on being the executive producer. He's like, man, you breaking my heart, man. Why you? And I'm like, bro, it's the same shit though. You know what I'm saying?
Expanding
like,
I'm
still in it. Yeah. Like, nigga, we here, nigga. You know what I'm saying? On some music shit. We in New York. You know what I'm saying? We got meetings, all type of shit. So it's the same thing. It's just I'm just not focused on just making beats all day. But what I was saying, what I was getting to with when I departed from the Olympics from 2012 to 2016, just the process of getting a national placement, it's draining. Like, nigga, I submitted beats and was fucking stalking A&Rs for years to get one placement. So just because the game was changing. Like now you see producers, like the main thing you see is like niggas on Instagram playing beats and you know what I'm saying? Like it's different from when I first got in the game. And that shit was draining. You know what I mean?
What was the critical decision that made you want to depart from the Olympics?
It wasn't really. It wasn't my decision. I got kicked out. I got kicked out of the fucking Olympics. That's the real tea. Like I'm gonna keep it all the way 100. I got kicked out. And we can laugh about it now. They're my brothers. I love them to death. Knox, Fab, Flawless, BP. Them my niggas. You know what I'm saying? Like Knox, we was just fucking at my game room gaming the other day. Fab was there too. But man, I didn't explain this story like 3 or 4 times, but I'll give it to y'all. But pretty much when we did that, when we started the Olympics, to be clear, and this is real shit, nobody's gonna say anything to this. I started the Olympics, far as it was my idea. It actually came from one of my homeboys that passed away. Shout out to Flame, rest in peace, Flame. But Flame was getting beats from all of us. And one day we was kicking it, we was chilling, and he was like, yo, man, y'all should start a group. Cause PL, which was one of my good friends, my brother, he was signed to a local label called Ready Rock. Mm-hmm. And they had a studio in Ipsy. And we all was working out of that studio. Me, Flawless, BP, and then I brought Knox out here to, I introduced him to J-Fab and BP and Flawless. And we was just working together crazy for like a whole year, just in that studio, just working. And Flame, he was like, yo, man, y'all should start a group. Y'all niggas work together. You know, you already work together. Y'all should start a production team. And I'm like, man, that's a good idea. And I called them niggas. I set up a conference call, like, for all of us to get on the phone. And I threw them the idea. And we ran with it. The thing that...
was around, what, 2009, 10-ish?
Yeah, like, no, hell no. This is like 2006, I think.
Earlier than that.
Yeah, I think it was like 2006. Like, it was way, like, because it took us, like, kind of... it took us like a year for like shit to start popping. So I want to say 2006, 2007. But anyhow, I had reached out to them. They like, yeah, like that's a good idea, whatever, we do it. And then later on down the line, when it came to the business and setting up the, you know, we set up the LLC, but doing the operational agreement, explaining how you run the company, we did a contract amongst each other, putting clause in it and putting rules in it that bit me in the ass. So one rule was like, we had a penalty system. So it's like, if you get three penalties, that's grounds for termination. So like, it was shit like, we had a fucking Dropbox that we all shared, and we would throw beats in there every week. Mm-hmm. And we had like a certain amount of beats that we had to put in the beat file, in the beat Dropbox. So 2010, my daughter was on the way. I was going through a lot of shit. We was having a lot of success. We was getting a lot of placements, but due to it being five of us, like the money was being broke up. Like we'd get $100,000 check, and at the end of the day, like when it comes to what I'm getting personally, it'd be fucking $12,000, because you got taxes, you got lawyer fees, you got the motherfucker who brokered the deal and splitting it five ways. So with that being said, the money wasn't adding up to the success. So that caused me to
that
do.
That sound like every group story, don't
you? Exactly, yeah. Real mm-hmm. shit. This is real shit. And that caused me to venture off and not focus on producing and do other shit, because it got to make sense for me. And I got a daughter on the way.
Right.
So when it came to like the beat quota and all that shit, I was falling short because I wasn't focused on producing. And I was so we it's crazy because me, Fab, and Knox talked about this the other day, and I was like, man, I'ma hold myself accountable because I know I was on bullshit. Me and even though the money wasn't matching up to my liking, uh-huh. like I still had like we was in the game. And I was supposed to be focused on that because we could have been way bigger than what we were. And me not being focused on producing, it was bullshit to a certain extent because I was young, you know what right. I'm saying? But all in all, like, nigga, them niggas, I was not focused on producing and they weren't feeling it. And it was like, hey, you got to go. And I'm like, damn, really? Yeah. Page 9 states that, nigga, if you, this your third strike. So we voting you out. And that shit was tough for me. But I'm so thankful for it. Because
that was an experience, though, something you
needed. Yeah, I needed that shit. Yeah. I needed that shit. And it's crazy. It may sound crazy to some people, like, man, how the fuck? But real shit, I'm so thankful for that moment. But I was so hurt. Like, nigga, tears came out.
No,
as
imagine.
A man, I could admit that. Like, I was sick. Like, bro, what is y'all doing? You know what I'm saying? And they'll tell you the same. Like, they regret making that decision. Because it was other shit that played into that. That it's a lot, man. But they'll tell you, like, that was fucked up. Because I don't want to say that. I'm not going to say that. But I'm going to say this. it's not what it was supposed to be with the Olympic brand, with me departing from them. Like, uh-huh. It was five of us. Now it's two. The Olympics was based off of five rings. Five niggas. It can't. You know what I mean? But it is what it is. Now my brothers, I love them to death. But that's what it was. You know what I'm saying? But like I say, man, it was a blessing in disguise for me. Now that I look back at it,
I appreciate you sharing that story.
It sounds like for sure, like it just motivated you more. Hell, you know what I'm saying? When that happened, you know what I'm saying? He's like, damn, you know, like these niggas really kicked me out. So
yeah, it opened my eyes. Yeah, because my back was against the wall. Because I had it dawned on me, like, damn, like it everything was just flashing. Like, damn, like I didn't help build this shit up, and now I got to start all over. And I didn't can't like we. At that time, we was, I don't think we was platinum at that time. We was gold because we had produced on the Teflon Don album, the I'm Not a Human Being album, and I think they were certified gold at the time. So it was just like, and then we was on fire. Like, I think it happened in 2012, 2011, 2000. We was on fire. Yeah. We was on everything, bro. Like, ASAP Rocky, first shit, like, the Long Live ASAP Project. Teflon Don, I'm Not a Human Being, like we Big Sean, the fucking bullshitting single that was supposed to be on the album but didn't make the album. That's another story. We was in the video, like it was just so much shit going on. Into like when that shit reality really kicked in for me, like you're no longer a part of this. It was like, whoa, yeah,
that gotta be devastating, man.
What the fuck, nigga? What, you know what I'm saying? So it woke me up. And like I said, it was a blessing because it created a beast. You know what I'm saying? When it comes to business, and I needed that shit.
Side of things,
right? Yeah. So
I think going into that type of stuff, you don't really be thinking about the whole business.
Fuck
side of things.
Nah. It was. I remember the process of creating the operational agreement, and I was just sitting back like, yeah. So we want to put this in there. Oh yeah, for sure. We want to put this in there. Oh yeah, put that in there.
Because I'm gonna tell you, you didn't think it was gonna be you.
Hell,
that was gonna
no.
caught up in that shit.
No,
yeah,
no, because these are my brothers.
Yeah, right?
You know what I'm saying. And it was and the thing about the decision that they made, it was just a lot of emotion because it's a lot of other shit that happened with that. You know, us getting into it, certain me getting into it with certain members and them persuade. Like it was so much shit, but. We all know what it is. We all move past it, and I love them niggas to death. All of them.
That's what's up.
You know what I'm saying? I'm closer to some than others, but them all, we made history. Like, I'm a platinum producer today because of being in the Olympics. Not to say if I wasn't in the Olympics, I wouldn't have made it, but that's what it was. So them my niggas. You know
one of the biggest things I love to hear about this is y'all cool still.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all
yeah.
work that shit out. You yeah. know what I'm saying? Y'all able to get past that. So that's
a big thing. And we done been through some shit. We done got into a lot of blood stupid shit, you know, whatever little differences we may have. But we done did so much. We done been through so much. That always dawned on everybody. Like, man, it's my brother at the end of the day. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we did some
that's
crazy
how I feel about
shit.
You niggas.
At some point, we're going to have to kick Curt off the podcast.
Sparta kicked this nigga off the podcast for sure.
It's all good,
like,
bro.
But no.
Do you guys ever plan to work together again?
That's crazy because when I was talking, when Knox and Fab was at the game spot, that's what he was talking about.
Is that
about.
Where that picture came from with all three of
you? Yeah, kind of. Yeah, you know, and that's what's crazy. Like, we got so much love for each other. Anytime we get together, it's always a good time. We laugh, we kick it, we reminisce. Like, them my brothers, like, it's the energy. You can't fake energy, bro. Mm-hmm. So if you, like, if y'all don't see each other for fucking 3 years from now, y'all get together and it's this, that's how you know it's real.
Yeah.
So
kind of
that's why I'm
like our thing for real.
Yeah. So that's why I put emphasis on that because I've known these niggas for a long. I know Knox, I was fucking 13. I'm about to be 35. You know what I'm saying? So no matter what we go through, no matter what happened, like, when we get together, it's always a good fucking time.
Our brotherhood.
That's
exactly.
pretty much with all that's of y'all, up. Though. Like, yeah. even when you bring PL into the picture.
Yeah.
When y'all are in a setting and y'all get together, it's like watching y'all be kids.
Exactly. That's exactly. Yeah.
That's dope. Yeah, that's fire. Every time he was talking, I just kept thinking about the podcast and everything we've been through.
Yeah, I mean, shit, the shit with me and UNG, when that shit, yeah, and that shit collapsed like that, and we had to start the other shit. You know what I'm saying? So, no, like, you know what I'm saying? And I agree with that. Like, when niggas get back together and this shit happens, you know what I'm saying, when we had our difference, you know what I'm saying, when that shit get back together and then, you know, bring it back. It's unstoppable.
Yeah, for real.
Yeah, that's that shit talking right now. By the way, I'm over stuttering this shit. Like,
I'm gonna blame this whole interview on that. So if I say something off the wall, ten minutes from now,
that shit,
just know that shit kicking.
Hey, look, whatever's left is yours, dog. So that's you.
Oh
so,
man, y'all gonna have me. I ain't gonna be able to drive home.
Don't drink it on the way.
Keep that thing, save it for later, man. We about to have y'all like that.
Down the whole bottle.
You know when you get drunk, you just keep drinking.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying.
Trust me. God, no.
Not knowing what you're doing.
These niggas had me fucked up last week.
Yeah, off that Mark Wahlberg tequila. That shit terrible.
What's that? What's the name of it?
I don't even know the fucking name of it, but that shit is terrible.
Liquid Death.
Yeah, that name. Yeah,
I don't know the name.
It's a really nice bottle. It looks like it's nice.
It's terrible.
And it smelled better than a fucking Sempre.
It's terrible.
I'm gonna try it. I know I'm fucking up any form of Pomelo.
Yeah, we trying to get some sponsorships and shit. These niggas like we gonna holler at her. She like, this shit is terrible on the goddamn show.
Oh yeah, you can't.
You can't do that, man.
Damn.
But nah, yeah, that shit. This shit's a problem.
But it's smooth. It's smooth.
It feels good.
Yeah, and it's smooth.
And you see, the color too is not gold. It's like a kind of like silver gold type shit. Look at the color. The color is not. It's not ridiculous. Okay. You know what I'm saying? It's proper reposado. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Because niggas be adding like other shit to their reposado to make the color and everything.
I drinking that fucking Casamigos.
Man, Casamigos is super stepped on.
That Don Julio. I gotta stop drinking that.
It's a tequila that I want to talk about. Because I got a bar at the crib, bro.
Man, yeah. Shit, me too.
I don't remember the fucking name. I can't remember the name.
Remember the shape of the bottom?
Damn, nope.
There's another one too.
It ain't nothing fancy. Like it's some basic shit.
Oh man, please don't say Milagro. Please don't say Milagro.
I'm sure that's not what it's gonna be.
I hope not.
Niggas think they be doing something with that shit.
That shit is terrible, man.
It's terrible.
Nigga. Well, Trump got out of office. Niggas ain't had that money no more. Niggas, so they had to jump to that shit, man. So the pandemic bans have been gone, bro.
It's terrible. That's so true. It's not even funny. Like, niggas was on, jumping niggas, to Milagro. Like,
niggas was on 1940.
Y'all think because it's the bottle tall and skinny that it's like having
niggas be trying. Niggas be trying to swear by that shit. Like, this shit good.
I
like,
know,
this,
that shit is hey, terrible.
Bitch, I am not fucking with
Julio?
That.
You don't like Milagro. No? Huh?
I changed her life.
Good. I'm glad you don't know what it is.
No. You know, I do know.
Stay away.
And look, I had you repeat it because I'm like, is this the shit?
Stay the fuck away from that shit. Yeah, Don Julio.
Anything that you make in mass, which I learned past meeting Ant, anything you make in mass that's a liquid is going to be terribly made because now they're trying to force it into production to meet the demand. Mm-hmm. That's why anything that's not in high demand is better quality.
That's why Hennessy is trash now.
That's how they fucked up Ciroc. That's how they fucked up 1800. Yep. That's how they, because 1800 used to be a good tequila. Mm-hmm. You got fucked up, but it used to be a good tequila.
1800.
I'm about to show my age, nigga. 2005, nigga. When I graduated from high school,
look,
nigga.
We used to drink that
gold, nigga. We wasn't doing the shit. We had the gold at that time, dog.
Oh no,
man.
Look,
we had the gold.
Drink 1800 with Moet Rosé.
Oh hell,
that shit.
You know how you
drunk.
That's
you
a
lay
wild.
Down and it feel like you falling.
Yeah.
Can't stop.
That was me last week.
Cause you over there mixing
falling
shit.
Falling and can't stop.
You over there,
I hate that.
You over there mixing
bro.
Champagne and shit, dog. That's the problem, nigga.
Yeah,
like champagne
is
the worst shit.
That's
the
worst. And tequila and champagne.
Man, look, this
stop.
Is my nigga.
Now look, the
when
rose
I
was my chaser.
When I was birthday party and they was trying to give me
the rose was
the
chaser.
Over, that, no. No, y'all
that's
have to
what
stop
it was.
Doing
I'm just,
it.
It is
to the
chaser.
This
look,
is past tense.
Look,
I'm speaking on what used to go down. We were in a club. We take a shot of the 1800. We got the rose bottle. We sipping on that all night.
That's crazy.
Look, I'm gonna tell you some dangerous ass shit. This nigga Black, dog. We was in the SAR studio,
oh,
dog.
Lord.
This nigga Black had fucking Deleon and that shit. Rosé and fucking Hennessy. He called that shit Thug Passion. I'm like, nigga, you out your fucking mind.
The fucking nerve. Talk about, what is it? The pet milk?
Yeah. And they call her Chata pet milk. He's like, nigga was mad as hell when he got that shit.
That's crazy.
But nah, man, state
that shit y'all had me on last week.
Yeah, that's that Mark Wahlberg. Blame Tizzy. You could say fuck Tizzy on air. Say it.
He was just trying to say get rid of that.
That's my bro,
shit.
Man.
No, nah, but he definitely fucked you up. No, with that
fuck
shit.
You.
Nigga, you don't want to. I
tried to convince you not to do it.
Yeah, you kept doing
I
that shit.
Was
I kept
the
saying like yeah, bro, like, you want you don't have to
peer
do
pressure
this
a motherfucker.
You don't have to do this shit.
You
I said
it
it.
Like a G though.
You did. Like I will give you that, but I told you you didn't have to do that shit.
Towards the end of the podcast, which is my favorite part of the podcast.
Oh man, slurring
like, literally,
all dog.
That nigga was
like, can we end this shit?
I was fighting for my life for sure.
I feel like man. I was on one of them things on the playground where you just spin around and you hold on. I'm like, nigga, let me off this podcast immediately.
Bruh.
Yeah, man.
I saw two of your ass.
I gave this nigga double shots of that shit too, dog. Like,
so that's three double shots back to back.
There's another tequila. I'm gonna put this on air.
I'm getting the name of this shit.
Nah, I'm gonna put this on air. You stay the fuck away from this shit. Anything Casino Azul, stay the fuck away from that shit.
And Corzo.
No, that ain't it either.
Nah, but that Corzo's another one too. You stay the fuck away from them too.
That's that white bottle.
No, that's damn, what the fuck is that name? I know what you're talking about too, with the painted bottle and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck. No, let me.
I'm about to get the name, but
I'm about
to
get the name right now because it's crazy. It's on the tip of my tongue, nigga, but I can't fucking remember that shit.
I'm just having fun.
Closet. It's Closet Azul.
No, right?
Closet. That's the name of that
oh,
shit.
Yeah,
that's
no,
with
no.
That white, with
yeah.
The blue?
Yeah, with the blue and shit Closet. Oh, okay. Yeah. That one's. That
you know
one.
They hand paint all that shit?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
That one's decent.
That's
it's
not that hard.
It's
hand paint. You know
that was like
Mexicans
popular in the pandemic
because
it.
Hell yeah,
it cost
because
so much,
the bottle and shit, you know, the little ring, the bell,
yeah,
and all that
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, niggas was cashing on that. Everybody
nigga,
had that.
Nigga, I was on a Michael Jordan. I was on a Michael Jordan back then, nigga. The Censoro. I was on a Michael Jordan.
I'm
nigga,
not fucking
nigga, I had my ass turning yellow.
I didn't even have a whole shot of that shit, and I was fucked up.
Hold on.
The jaundice, nigga. That shit.
How the fuck did you pronounce that?
Stay the fuck with El Jimador? That shit is terrible. Oh, my God. You got that at the bar?
Yep.
Pour that shit out. Pour that shit out now, nigga. Pour that shit the fuck
that
out.
Was kinda smooth.
No, pour that shit out. That shit is terrible. Oh. Yeah,
wow.
Nigga, that you talking about some stepped on shit. That shit is stepped on, nigga. That shit mixed with vodka.
Oh shit.
Yeah, you gotta get the fuck up. Yeah, get that shit the fuck up out of here.
Give me a tequila that you
yeah, take
would
that
recommend.
Shit with you. I'm
give me a tequila
I don't
that you
no
would recommend.
How we drink them on the show?
Herradura.
I know, but
right,
wait,
I'm like
Herradura. His
yeah, you take yeah. That. You take that shit with you. That's
I go
yours.
Do the podcast and get a bottle of liquor.
Yeah. That's gonna
like,
be that's gonna be a thing.
Week.
That's gonna be a thing. That's gonna be a thing.
Y'all need me as a co-host. I'm here.
That's gonna be a thing. But nah, Herradura is a good one. I'm can't believe I'm putting this shit on the air. Herradura.
Oh, everybody know it. Herradura is y'all about to fuck that shit up.
What about
that's fine.
Cabo Wabo.
Stay the fuck away from that too.
God damn.
Yeah.
I told you.
Stay the fuck away from that one. But the other shit you brought to the first podcast we ever did.
Look, I didn't know.
I offered you something. You're like, nah, I'm good. And you just sat there and
I didn't know
that
who
shit.
The fuck he was. I'm like, who is this weird nigga with 9 bracelets offering me fucking tequila? Like, I don't know this. Kurt wasn't here. It was awkward.
Just me and Jason talking.
Look, but fuck the tequila. Y'all try the golden pineapple.
Golden pineapple.
I had that before. It was good as mother.
You had it?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah, okay. Yeah. I've been to more than like, I'm an all-star in that bitch, so you know, they know me by the first name of that.
Any
bitch.
Bougie-ass that restaurant that exists.
But nah, I'm gonna give you some other names too, man. So I'm gonna get you together, dog, because we gotta take care of you, dog. We gotta take care of you.
Absolutely.
For real.
Y'all did.
Get them
all.
Yeah,
I got this shit. I got this shit.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell you off air where to get that shit from. It's out of stock. It's out of stock at one place. It's out of stock at one of the places, but I'm gonna tell you where the other one is. So I got you.
Damn, this is like
It's hitting
it's
like,
rare like that.
It's hitting like that. Yeah, it's hitting
selling,
like that.
Flipping this shit, you know I'm a. I'm a hustler.
Don't do no white. Don't do it like the white Hennessy, dog.
Some tequila that they don't have.
Personal.
They only got it in one store.
Don't do it.
I see it in your story. I'm reporting.
No, this gonna be.
Don't
black
do it.
Market.
Don't do it like the white. Don't do it like the white Hennessy.
Oh, I'm fucking up y'all sponsor.
No, you good. You good.
That's
no,
the liquor.
Nigga, that's the sponsor we want right here.
Now I know
we
that,
want this sponsor
that,
right
I'm
here.
Selling
shit.
Selling this shit.
Hell
under
yeah,
the
we want that sponsor right there, nigga. That shit is good, nigga. Yeah. So, no, we good, man.
Can't wait till we get a sponsor, bro.
We gonna get one soon, man. We gonna get one soon.
If I don't fuck it up first.
What you gotta do to do that? You gotta just hit him up, like, hey.
Shit, you ask this man right here. He hit up Sinfrey, and they gave him a sponsorship. They gave him some bottles and shit. So you know.
Oh damn.
Yeah, it can happen.
Damn.
It can happen. Like, nigga, for the wrestling podcast, nigga, we got two on deck right now. We got a
Is Captain J's one of them?
No, not yet. Not yet. We're working on that one, though. But no, Magic Spoon, the cereal company. Mm-hmm. We got that one. And Manscaped. They're looking to holler at us. Oh, Manscaped. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What? Is that shit that they be talking about on...
it's on every Wallow. Yeah, it's on every fucking podcast. Okay. Every fucking they sponsor every fucking podcast. That's only one of the easiest ones you can get. Manscaped. Okay. And Raycon too, apparently. Because Raycon's been sponsoring the fuck out of people too.
Ray J.
Yeah, Ray J. Yeah, Ray J been sponsoring niggas. Damn. They giving niggas free earbuds, you know. Free shit. Yeah, Ray J be giving niggas free shit. Yeah. We gonna get there.
Okay.
We gonna get there. Cool.
Mm-hmm. Well, before we wrap things up, I would like to say, because I believe in giving my friends their flowers while they're alive.
Of course.
Just to recap, because I did say at the beginning of the podcast, the PC is one of my favorite producers. And I don't think that you all realize your effect that the Olympics had on the city. Oh. And I don't think that y'all have gotten the, well, I don't believe in accolades. But I don't believe you all have gotten the credit that you all deserve for what you contributed to the city. Because you all were the first to do something that has not happened here in Detroit. And I've heard a lot of people say shit like, oh, like they were just producers, they just made beats. Y'all brought awareness that there were talented people in Detroit. And y'all were in an era in which there was so much shit going on in that time frame. You had Big Sean blowing up, you had PL blowing up, DJ Mo Beats. Like there was so much going, like every time I reflect on that time period, it reminds me of Paid in Full. That's what every party was like to me. So as an appreciation point or as a fan, I do want to say I appreciate everything that you all contributed to music and that don't ever diminish what you, Knox, Jay, Fab, Flawless, and BP have contributed to music because y'all are legends from the city.
Appreciate that. That's real shit.
Oh, that was well spoken. Yeah.
Man. You do this shit, nigga.
He's going for the sis.
Yeah, I did
clap. He's gonna get the right button.
Yeah. Yeah, I do the clap, man. That was awesome. That was awesome. I do the claps.
Mm-hmm. Clapping.
That felt very.
That was aggressive as fuck. That was very aggressive.
Y'all keep calling me aggressive on the show, bro.
You was clapping, nigga. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm.
That clapping felt like a whole nother type of clapping. But go ahead, do your thing.
I was about to say something real crazy out the way.
Thank you
but
for not.
I'm not.
Definitely not. Yeah.
Anyway, this has been a great episode. Mm-hmm. Good to have a guest. We don't have too many guests on the show, so it's good that you swing by.
Appreciate that. Yeah. Appreciate y'all.
Damn, man. That's crazy. We ain't going to have too many guests on the show like that, though.
Why not? Why not?
Not every blue moon. It got to be special. So, and this episode 10, that's true. So appreciate
you. Oh, damn. 10.
Yeah. Technically, special. We did like a lot of episodes. This is like our third podcast. So this is like,
I ain't gonna ask no questions.
Yeah, we'll talk about it off here. Yeah, but it's like technically what, like episode what, 120 or some shit like that? If you just combine everything together though.
Damn. No.
Yeah, man.
There's a lot of bullshit.
It was getting busy, man. When we first started doing podcasts, niggas didn't even know what a podcast was and shit, so. Been doing this shit for a long time.
Damn.
Yeah.
That's deep.
Yeah, man. Damn. That's crazy. Yo ass, man.
The fuck did I do?
Nothing, man. I just appreciate you.
Oh, man.
I look, you know, just listening to him, just talking about everything that he went through, I just started thinking about everything.
Kurt
don't
want us to
through.
Kick us off. Kick him off the
podcast. I mean, y'all can kick me off. New Edition kicked off Bobby Brown. You see what, shit, that nigga had a monster album.
It was never the same.
Hey, yeah, man, it's all good. I'll be Bobby Brown, man, just without cooking the chicken and crap.
Man, we all good, man. We got, Jesus Christ. we all good, man. We gotta go to reach, man. You know, we gonna make this shit happen.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, definitely. So,
yeah, man. Thanks, PC, for coming to the show. Can you give us some, thank you. Name some of hit some of them other ones real quick. They got some gunshots in there.
No,
not the hit. Not the other one.
Don't
no.
Yeah.
No, that definitely ain't it. Damn it! I ain't pressing no more, man.
You buzzing?
Nah, hell yeah, I'm buzzing. What?
Shame.
You don't drink with us no more, so you don't be knowing.
Yeah. Point that shit again. Exactly, nigga. Is that shit right there? Yes.
Yeah. But this has been episode 10 of Most Known Unknown.
We got a game show next week.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. You want to talk about it?
Yeah. Before we go. Yeah, my birthday. I'll be 36. We got a game show, man. You know, so we're going to have a, like, a semi-live audience. You know what I'm saying? I got buzzers, too. So y'all niggas better be ready for that shit. You know,
okay.
$100 gift card on the line for whatever the fuck you want to go to, because I ain't. I was gonna do like 500, but nigga, no, we're not doing 500. We gonna do 100. So
damn, nigga, why not the fuck?
A game show. So what do that?
It's gonna be consistent, like things that about me. You know what I'm saying? Okay. So it's gonna be some shit like that. We're gonna do like some Jeopardy. You know?
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Yeah. So we're gonna do some shit like that. So
you might have known him longer, but I know him better.
On that
note, drink some water real quick. You know what I'm saying?
On that note,
shout out to Core Water, man. We need a sponsorship from y'all niggas. So
yeah, we need a sponsorship
from somebody. We need money.
That I won't fuck up. I won't fuck it up.
Yeah, exactly.
Y'all, but y'all don't be coming for Asja, man.
Y'all gotta cut the bullshit.
Yeah, one more thing too, man. Come on, come on, bro. Come on, Ock, man. You listen to All Bullshit Considered, the Curt Will podcast, and this shit, nigga. You know who the fuck she is, bro. Like, come on, man. We know what time it is,
girl.
Dog.
Like, for real.
Yeah, but you know.
Take me off. What do you say? 5 episodes? 3 episodes?
Couple episodes.
Low management.
Thank you. I mean, this a nigga that got that Drewski cussed out on the show and shit. So he was on Could Have Been Records. You know what I'm saying? That nigga Drewski.
No, that was dope.
Yeah, clowned his ass. Like, what the fuck are you rapping about, nigga? I want to hear all these words and shit. All this lyrical.
That nigga was spitting though.
Ock can rap.
Was
like,
he though?
Yeah, he can.
We ain't
about to do that.
Did you see this shit?
What?
He cold.
Okay.
You heard Frank Castle, right? Mm-hmm. He was on Still Focus. Mm-hmm. Oh, Jesus Christ. All right, man. We out, man.
Yeah, we out, man.
It's not the tequila. Don't blame it on that.
Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. We out, man. We all at you, man.
We out. Ooh.